Some planets in our solar system are rocky, and some are gaseous. Even gas giants orbiting our solar system have rocky moons. Currently, there are more than 200 moons in the solar system. Why aren't some moons in the solar system made of gas? Does the universe contain gaseous moons? Even though there are no gaseous moons in the solar system, it may still be possible under the right conditions. Several factors are involved, including the mass of the moon, ambient temperature and wave forces, as well as the gravitational pull of any nearby object, such as the planet orbiting the moon. Let's take the moon, as it's a rock, and then create a hydrogen atmosphere around it. We know thermal effects will cause the hydrogen atmosphere to escape very quickly. The warmth of the sun would cause the hydrogen to evaporate away. Gases such as hydrogen are much less dense than rock, so the moon would grow to the size of the Earth. Therefore, it would be more appropriate to call the gas moon a binary planet, as it's likely to have the same size as its parent planet. We can conclude from this that a hydrogen-only moon will not be stable. But even if our imaginary gas moon were as big as Earth and the temperature around it was too cold, the host planet would tear it up. Also, because it's so small, gravity won't be powerful to hold those light elements together. As with gaseous planets, the gas must be larger than its rock counterpart. This is because if it were too small, it would not have enough gravity to hold lighter gases like methane. Our moon is subject to tidal forces from Earth, but it doesn't decompose because it's combined with some physical force. Since the hypothetical gaseous moon is gas, not a solid, even if it's very cold, if it orbited around another planet, then the moon would be tidally stripped by the tides. So how is it possible to have a gaseous moon? It would have to be extremely distant and very cold, or very large. It's not possible to work on a body as large as our moon anywhere in our solar system. Can it work in interstellar space? Probably not. Certainly, you can make something as big as a planet around Jupiter, for example, Neptune. The gravitational forces holding these huge bodies together would likely prevent tidal forces from destroying the Neptune-like moon. There could be two types of gaseous moons. One could have a rocky or metallic core that formed on the edge of the protoplanetary disk and then migrated inward. The other could only be gas without a solid core, but this is rare. Astronomers have detected what appears to be the first moon outside our solar system. This is a gaseous world that's about the size of Neptune and orbits a gas giant much larger than Jupiter. By solar system standards, it's a big and strange moon known as an exomoon because it's outside the solar system. All of the moons in our solar system are rocky or icy. The newly discovered bodies are both gaseous, an unexpected pairing. About 5,400 light-years away from Earth, they're located in the constellation Cetus. The Hubble Space Telescope and Kepler Space Telescope provided the first clear evidence of an exomoon, but more Hubble observations will be needed to confirm the discovery. The exomoon is exponentially larger than the largest moon of our solar system, Jupiter's moon Ganymede, which has a diameter of 3,270 miles. According to estimates, the exomoon has a diameter of approximately 30,600 miles, about the same as that of Neptune, the smallest of our solar system's four gas planets. The exomoon's mass is about 1.5% that of its planet. Its size and gaseous composition challenge current moon formation theories. The main reason we don't have gas moons is that they're not big enough. Because gas has a high degree of movement, it's very volatile, making it easy to escape. All bodies in the solar system with gas in their atmospheres experience this process. However, the rate at which they lose gas tends to be very slow. A high movement rate means objects have to reach a certain size before they can hold on to an atmosphere. Almost all moons fall below this size limit. The moon's gravitational influence usually cannot rival that of its parent planet since it's so small. As a result, the planet usually robs moons around it of its gas. Gas moons, similar to gas planets, are not possible. Closest you could get would be a binary planet system with roughly similar size gas planets orbiting each other. Gas binary planets may exist, but they're very rare because planetary formation usually results in two planets merging or separating from each other. As a result, gas satellites have not been discovered. If you like this video, please consider subscribing and click the notification bell so you do not miss any upcoming videos.